Welcome back. I'm Wolf Blitzer here in Moore, Oklahoma, right outside of Oklahoma City. We're watching this disaster unfold. It's still a disaster. It's been a little over 24 hours since a massive tornado tore a 17-mile-wide long gash through Oklahoma, and we're just beginning to learn the full scope of the destruction. It is enormous. The state insurance commissioner says the tornado damage will probably top $1 billion. Now appears the storm is even more powerful than we originally thought. The National Weather Service now saying damage assessments show winds reached 200 miles an hour or even higher, and that would make it an EF5 tornado, the highest level of intensity. Emergency crews have been searching board by board through the rubble. More than 100 people were rescued after the tornado hit. At least 24 people were killed. 237 people were injured. This disaster is hard on everyone here in Moore, Oklahoma, especially the kids. Many of them huddled in their schools. They were terrified as the winds howled and the roof and the walls came down. Jake Tapper is here. He's covering the story for all of us as well. You spoke to a fifth grader who had an amazing story.
Well, you know, it's what's so remarkable is, and we've seen this with all the individuals here in Moore, is how much this community has come together and how brave they are in the face of this. But what's really even more remarkable is how brave these kids are. We met one of them. Her name is Lauryn Fugate. She was walking with her parents, and we talked to her about her horrific experience. And really, I don't think I've met very many people as brave as this young girl.
The roof caved in on all of us while we were in the school.
And where were you? Did you go to the basement?
Well, the fifth and the sixth graders were all huddled in the bathrooms. And all we heard was a lot of rumbling and then stuff falling on our heads.
Did something fall on your head?
Yeah.
What fell? Just parts of the ceiling?
Parts of the roof and stuff. So I know that the vent fell on my best friend, Mackenzie. So.
Is she okay?
Yeah.
What grade are you in?
I'm in fifth grade.
And how did the fifth graders do?
A lot of them were scared crazy, but some of them were bleeding worse than others, but yeah.
Did everybody make it?
Most of us did.
And what was it like when you guys found her? Let me get you guys into
the school was just flattened, and then they had her searching for her, and then they brought her. One of the moms had her and brought her out to me. She was covered in dirt. And
where were you? Had you run to the school? Or
I had run to her friend's house because that's where she was supposed to be after school. And of course, that was the backside of it where everything was on fire and everything. So I was just going to the house, which was gone, and looking for her. So.
And tell me about the moment when you saw her.
Oh, it was very emotional. I mean, kind of in shock seeing her all wet and dirty, but yeah.
She kept it together.
We got it together, yeah. I mean.
What was it like to see your mommy?
I started crying, and I, like, hugged her and stuff. I was like, I love you, Mom, and yeah.
It must have been a pretty good hug.
Yes.
A remarkable story from a remarkable young girl, and this whole community is full of stories like that. There has been obviously way too much death and destruction, but many, many more survivors and stories like that about people who did survive and were able to be reunited today.
Yeah, and this is an area, this is a community, as I said, 50 or 60,000 people. This is a major suburb of Oklahoma City, a city of about 600,000. So, you know, normally we hear these tornadoes go through rural areas, but this is almost like Bethesda is to Washington, D.C., or Arlington is to Washington, D.C., areas that you and I know well. This is the same thing.
Absolutely, and we've been driving around now to make it to this live shot, and the destruction, you know, a lot of it we haven't even seen yet. A lot of people at home haven't seen because a lot of areas are cordoned off by police because of downed power lines and other dangers, or they're just trying to keep the media out of certain neighborhoods. It is really, really horrific.
No. This used to be a bowling alley right here. Can't hardly really see that bowling ball.
Are those bowling balls?
Yeah. So they were thrown around. Cars were thrown around.
No, well, that's the thing, the shrapnel. I mean, this type of thing is very dangerous.
Jake will be reporting tomorrow from here as well on the lead. Thanks very much.
Wolf.
Many Americans have watched the tornado disaster play out in real time on television. We've seen gripping pictures of the twister itself and the damage it left behind. Our Mary Snow has been going through all of the video that's been coming in to CNN.
Oh my gosh.
This is what it looked like coming face to face with the tornado that ripped through Moore, Oklahoma.
Not good. Please, dear God, please keep these people safe. Lots of debris in the air.
Is that a vortice on the side? Starting to.
Big, there's a whole roof that just came off.
Houses are completely leveled.
It doesn't even, it's unrecognizable.
Leveled, houses are leveled.
This doesn't even look like it was ever a development.
No, it doesn't.
For those in its path, a frantic race for cover.
You know, it was just unbearably loud, and you could see stuff flying everywhere, just about like on the movie Twister.
You know, they said it was coming, so I was like, well, what do we do? Do we have time to get in the vehicles to run it? We have pets. Or do we just hunker down? So we grabbed our motorcycle helmets and hid in the closet and prayed like hell. And luckily, the only rooms that were spared was the room we were in.
Caught outside with nowhere to go, this couple hid in a storm ditch.
I just kept saying over and over again, please, God, you know, let us be safe. Just protect us. And then, you know, while we were down under there, you know, I honestly felt like it was just going to come and suck us up in there. Like, I didn't, because there was like, it was too open. It was open on one side, open on the other. It was just like a bridge. So I was just scared that it was just going to take us. So I just kept praying to God.
For some parents whose prayers were answered after the Briarwood Elementary School took a direct hit, words failed to describe their relief. Trenda Purcell, seeing her son Camden, says it all.
Oh, he was so brave. Oh, he was so brave.
Communities wiped out in a matter of minutes, miles and miles of destruction. Those who made it say they feel lucky just to be alive. And within the rubble, there is resilience.
It's just phenomenal. And not a good phenomenon at all. But I'm going to be okay. We're going to get back. We're definitely Okies, and that's what we're known for. Just we'll come back, arms are swinging. So.
Mary Snow reporting thousands of people, thousands of stories like that, not just dozens or even hundreds, thousands of powerful stories that we're going to catch up with over the next several days. Up next, dozens who survived the tornado. They bear physical scars right now. Our own Dr. Sanjay Gupta is here. He'll join us live. We'll talk about the kind of injuries he's seeing. And weather experts take us inside the massive twister, a dangerous swirl of wind and debris.